Overpopulation, invasive species, lack of food. I spent the last 100 days trying to transform this aquarium into a real ecosystem. And it wasn't an easy task, because to be called an ecosystem, it needs to meet three main things: diversity, interdependence, and sustainability. If you throw a bunch of living beings inside a closed container, you're almost done. There are different organisms, so you can check diversity off your list, and for sure, they will interact with each other. And that's basically what interdependence means. But sustainability is the key to a thriving ecosystem. It means it must be capable of adapting to changes, and it ensures success in the long term. It's an extremely delicate balance. If the conditions favor one of the animals over the others, they will overpopulate. And once the balance is broken, the whole ecosystem spirals into decline. And believe me, I have experience on this topic, because somehow a leech made its way into another ecosystem I had. Long story short, it went from being a true ecosystem brimming with life to a wasteland where only the plants survived. I managed to save a couple of tens of snails before it was too late, and that is how this tank was created. I also added another species of snails to increase biodiversity, and plants, filter feeders, decomposers, you know, the whole ecosystem pack. I was upset after the leech incident, so I didn't want to make an aquarium I had to clean or feed. I preferred it to be on its own. But as you will see now, nothing was going to turn out the way I wanted. Because during the first month, there were few animals and too much food. And that caused the water to get cloudy. Millions of bacteria found in these waters an ideal place to develop. And if we check that cloud under the microscope, we can see the bacteria were a delicacy for the paramecia. Billions of different microorganisms created a rich universe inside my aquarium. The beauty of nature, aligned with a single objective: annoying me, by preventing me from enjoying the view of my creation. Although, I have to admit that those clouds of paramecia are mesmerizing when you watch at them in time-lapse. By the way, it would be awesome if you could interact with this video, so you help me getting a lighting system other than a torch and a silicone tube. I'm just asking for a like, we are so close to monetize this channel finally. Anyways, my eyes don't work in time-lapse, and so many microorganisms are still a nuisance. But they didn't know how powerful I am. I had a trained army, a fully armed battalion of sea shrimps ready to fight. They might seem small, but they love to eat microorganisms, and they have clear instructions to clone themselves as fast as they can. Everything was ready and the battle was started. But since it was going to take a while to be noticeable to the naked eye, I decided to add an eggshell. Not only because I wanted to see it disintegrate, but also because calcium is going to be important once all those snail eggs hatch. Our 20 brave pioneers had finished clearing the water, and quickly hundreds of their descendants took over the place. And at that moment, I realized that my response may have been too disproportionate. With so many snails hatching every day, such an overpopulation of ostracods was about to become a problem, a big competitor for the little food available in the ecosystem. The aquarium looks gorgeous now. The ostracods love to have such a big space for swimming. Free from predators, the snails feel safe, and their single objective is to reproduce. And I'm happy because I succeeded in creating a balanced ecosystem. That's exactly what I would say if things were going well. But a silent war was developing, and I couldn't notice it until it was too late. As you can see, at the beginning we had a great diversity of plants. Now, they are all gone. Only the water moss is still alive. The snails ate everything else. So once again, the ecosystem got overrun. Without producers transforming the sun's energy into organic matter, it wouldn't take long for all the animals inside to starve. I had to do something, and I had to do it fast. This is too ugly. Oof, this is too expensive. I already have this one. Huh, I kind of like it. In my experience, these floating plants are quick conquerors. You add one to your aquarium, and the next time you check on it, there are hundreds. But they are not in their prime. To give them an advantage over the snails, I'm sharing a pair with them. Snails don't excel in speed, so while we wait for them to find it, let's check on this week's findings.
in the aquarium.
Chironomid larvae. They love to dance. That's how they get the oxygen from the water. And they graze on macroalgae and other small particles. A random worm. I don't know what it is. But it looks just like an earthworm, but it's under the water. It's cool to have something big to watch when I... No. Ugh. Mayfly nymph. These things can't stand contamination, so it means we have a very clean water here. Flatworms. All I can say is I hope I haven't unlocked a new snail parasite. I don't want to start over again. Hydras, the jellyfish from the rivers. They are both beautiful and poisonous. They became an important animal because, hold on, the snails had found the bird, and it seems they were really hungry. But not everyone came to eat. We lost one of the ramshorn snails. It looked quite old, so it was probably at the end of its life. Anyway, I'm worried, because there are dozens of bladder snails, maybe hundreds, and I hadn't seen a single baby ramshorn yet. I know these guys need a lot of calcium to form their massive cells, and since they lay eggs non-stop, maybe the problem is the lack of this mineral, because the eggshell I introduced is still intact. So I created a sophisticated plan to fix this. I'm adding another eggshell, but crushed into small pieces. I hope they can use that calcium now. Do you know what happens when you add food, a pear, for example, to a closed environment like this? Exactly. Too many nutrients again. Microorganism colonization again. Cloudy water again. You know what? I'm tired. I'm changing the water. I don't care about balance anymore. And this is a desperate measure, but at this point, I'm very frustrated. If it's not the cloudy water, it's overpopulation or lack of food or lack of minerals, it starts to feel like an impossible mission to me. But at least not everything is wrong. The hydras found a paradise in my aquarium. After the harsh life in the wild, spending the whole day hunting for food, they are really happy here. There's so much food that it comes directly to their tentacles. So they can use all that energy to reproduce. They are small, but you shouldn't underestimate them. This one just ate a whole chironomid larva. I wish I had recorded it because I don't know how this happened. Another piece of good news is that this is not a dead mayfly nymph, but a mold. The underwater days are finally over. Now it has a whole lot of time. 2 days. If it's lucky, it will live for 2 days. To be honest, I was about to give up on this aquarium, and I feel it's still far from stabilizing. Since it doesn't contain a great diversity of plants, I'm adding a chunk of vegetation from a pond. Pay close attention, because this is supposed to be the last time I'm interfering with this ecosystem. If you're watching this from the future, I probably made one last video update about this project. Check out my channel if you want to know what happened. If you're not that far in the future, don't worry, you can subscribe to stay updated, or maybe you can make some time watching this video. It's very interesting as well.